when I got assigned to this, first sergeant told me, you're going to be in the Cheyenne. And I said, Cheyenne what? He said, you're going to be in the Cheyenne turret. That's a tail gunner turret that's been changed with a bigger aperture area with twin 50s. The first mission I made was because a guy didn't feel good. I was more scared when we took off than any time in the whole flight, though. You ain't in a pressurized aircraft. I'm up above, behind the bomb bay, above where my turret is. It's going like this and going like that. And when he's just above the ground, he's bringing the wheels up in the front, and it sounds like coming apart. Your suit was a sheepskin suit, leather. You had mittens with a trigger finger in them, and you had gauntlets clear up. And then you had an earphone, and you had your helmet was leather with sheepskin. And I'd go back to one of the spar sections and hang on and sit on my duffer in my suit. Then the aircraft commander would say, get into your gun stations. You're like on an ironing board at two different levels. Your ammo is fed into your guns by a tray. And then your spent rounds go into an asbestos apron. Your intercom system within the bomber itself was always active once you formed up.
There's Charlie doing his squirrel again.
One gun station will tell the other gun station on the intercom, Charlie's coming your way.
Enemy fighters at 7 o'clock high.
When you're in the sky, you have nothing to measure by. You don't know till you see your field of fire go out there. My 250s merge at 150 yards. In the tail gun section, the world's already gone by before you see it. You're looking at the back end of it.